When I'm in the US, I keep talking about this wonderful country to people. And this invitation gave me an opportunity to come back here. So I thank everyone here for calling me here. But other than this fact that, yes, personally, I'm extremely happy and honored to be here, thanks to this wonderful initiative by His Highness Dr. Aline. But other than that, I don't know whether I should be here. I'm not a great business leader. I'm a simple teacher, okay? I'm a high school counselor. I guide students for higher education in universities all over the world. And we have offices in India, in 4 offices in the Middle East, 1 office in the US, 16, 17 offices. And I am a founder of this company. When I founded this company in 1998, today we are Asia's top 10 in our line of business. So other than that, my subject is entirely different. I was telling my colleague today, I am feeling like a badminton champion who's in a squash court, you know? So that's it. I have a completely different reason to be in front of you today. By qualifications, I'm a chartered accountant with a national merit rank, but while doing my CA, my favorite subject was statistics because that analyzes the past to predict the future. I love to analyze what happened in the past to have a judgment on what will happen in the future. Leadership, where was it in the past, is a very, very good eye-opener to estimate where it will be in the future. You know? And that's going to be my work today, I hope. Yeah. So business leadership, yesterday, today, and tomorrow is what I'm going to talk about. Leadership for me is the power to change lives of people. And I've used the word people here and not followers alone. We feel that leaders change the lives of followers. I don't think so. Leaders change the life of people. They may be followers, they may not be, but that's a supreme power. That's a very, very important power, which historically was used as well as misused. But yes, the power of changing lives of people is one of the most supreme power that you can think of. Today I've decided to talk about business leadership, again for a particular reason. I know it's a business leadership conference, but even amongst leadership, okay, the biggest leaderships can be classified into religious leadership, political leadership, and business leadership. Amongst these three, historically, we started with religious leadership, which has the power to change the lives of people. Slowly, that leadership, the religious leadership, gave the powers to the political leaderships, and the political leaders had a bigger share, you know. So the power has shifted from religious to political, and from political to business leadership after the Industrial Revolution. Today, our lives are changed by business and economic leaderships more than political and religious leaderships, because business leadership does not know boundaries. For us, it's a one world. I started with a small office in 1998 in Mumbai, and today I have 15 offices in 5 countries, and we are growing very, very rapidly into different countries, because for us, borders doesn't mean anything. The internet revolution has increased the speed, and in tomorrow's world, the business leaders are going to have a better influence on the life of people, and I'm sitting in front of business leaders today. So it's you people who are going to have a bigger impact on the lives of people. Just imagine, we are all here to make sure that that impact is very, very positive. To make my point or to make my analysis, I have taken USA as a base for different reasons. One, US has been a place of global business power for more than 150 years, right? It has been a trendsetter in business and innovation, and about 54% of global market capitalization was concentrated in the US in the 1980. Today it stands at 40%, but even 40% is a mighty high. So the entire business valuation, 40% of that is accumulated in the US. So in the next 5 or 10 minutes, I will just see how the US business leadership has moved in the last 100 years. I will strongly recommend, if any one of you have not seen it, there is a BBC documentary on the same title, Men Who Built America. It's a 6-hour docudrama, and I love watching it because of its content, the delivery, it's beautiful. This documentary talks about 4 business leaders of the US. It talks about Rockefeller, Andrew Carnegie, who's a steel man, Rockefeller, who's an oil man, Vanderbilt, who's a railways person, and JP Morgan, the banker. These 4 were the richest people in the Americas by the end of 19th and the beginning of 20th century. And their contribution to the nation building of America is unprecedented. Now comes the most interesting part. They were later criticized and even prosecuted for social harm that they caused. Okay? Rockefeller for creating very unfair monopolies, Andrew Carnegie for opening fire on the workers of his company, Vanderbilt, the railway man, again for monopolies, and JP Morgan for unethical practices in the stock market. So what was considered to be a winning business strategy once upon a time became an illegal activity 50 years down the line, and actually laws were made to make sure that these activities are not repeated. So leaders of yesterday had become criminals of the future.